know these nations don't like me. Everything they do is out of spite, yeah. Cause they know that Bible talking about me. But we're strong through the power of his might, yeah. Yeah, I know these nations don't like me. Everything they do is out of spite, yeah. Cause they know that Bible talking about me. But we're strong through the power of his might, yeah. The Most High, I know he got me. Read the OT, you wanna know about me. They do, but don't doubt me. The good news, you can't stop it. Now that we waking up, studying the Bible, we cooking up. Everything looking up, 20 deep, we be pulling up. Teaching our people the truth.
That's who we are.
Showing scriptures for proof that what we do.
Shalom, shalom. We back for quarter two. Right. Thank you for staying tuned with us. Let's get right into it. Hey, let's see what we got in the local news, baby. Let's hit it. Let's get it. We're going local news straight out of Philly. Let's see what we got going on in Philly, man.
Bring it out.
Shout out to Deacon Ithon Upper and Captain Joel. Upper in Philly, the city of no brotherly love.
No, man, not now.
Let's scroll down. Let's read that real quick. Read that.
Even a pandemic can't slow Philly's gun violence.
Read that again. Dang.
Even a pandemic can't slow Philly's gun violence.
Even during the pandemic, Negroes still killing themselves out there.
Still hate each other.
Rick, scroll down. Let's read the article real quick. Let's see. Look at that. Somebody, right there, that's a picture. Somebody came through with a
AK.
With an AK.
Hold on. Go down.
Scroll down so we can
see
the
17.
18, 17.
Yeah, 20 something. See on the mic spoke? 20 something shots.
Ooh,
damn.
A lot. Go down. Let's see what we got. Read that real quick.
When Philadelphia's stay-at-home order came down on March 23rd, almost every facet of city life ground to a halt.
Right, read on.
Except Philadelphia's most unrelenting epidemic, gun violence.
Gun violence. That's what we doing. We out here killing each other when the script says, thou shalt not kill.
Bring it out.
And we stay doing that.
Yeah. We were talking about that earlier, Cap. Remember, it was like, damn. We want to see the end of our enemies to come, but that's not going to happen until Israel get their act together.
True.
We're trying to get up out of this. You want the Lord to step in. You got secrets of trying to poison us.
Yeah.
You got Flint, Michigan. All this happening. You want the Most High to step in, but look what's going on.
And,
what is this?
And that's it. We can't be a hypocritical nation.
I was just going to say that.
Bring it out.
No, yeah. We are the biggest hypocrites, man. We see the other nations beating us up, killing us, taking stuff from us, doing whatever, and we want to get in the street with guns and walk around and look all crazy. But when your brother kill your other brother,
nothing.
Hey, we ain't got nothing to do with that. Yeah. Don't say nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Are you kidding me?
Snitches get stitches.
Mm. Yeah. It's a no snitch policy when it's brother on brother.
Right.
But when Esau kill you, they want to tell
everybody want to say something.
Yeah. Everybody want to say something.
Hey, that's backwards as hell, man. I'm telling you. One brother, he did a thing. He went to the Aubrey location, right? He filmed it. He was like, okay, there was a big riot here. Not a big riot, but a big protest, right? A white man shoots down a black man. But when it comes to shootings like this, where's the protest?
It's none.
Where's the picket signs? Where's that?
It got to be, Chicago did it like a year or two ago. It got to be 800 murders in the city before we decide to say something is wrong with it.
They want to drag the McMichaels out and punish him on the spot.
Right.
Why you ain't dragging Ray Ray out?
Right. And that's why the Lord leave us in captivity. Because we're a hypocritical nation. We falsify the balance when it comes to judging.
Mm. Right.
That's why we still here. We ain't learned justice. We ain't learned true judgment amongst ourselves.
Right.
Holding ourselves accountable as a people.
Right.
We hypocrites as a nation. Go back to the article. Let's read. Scroll down on it some and let's read. Read that. Yeah, go ahead, man. Go ahead with that. Read
Since
that.
Mayor Jim Kenney closed schools, shuttered non-essential businesses, and told residents to stay home to slow the spread of coronavirus, at least 135 people have been shot.
That's only been a few weeks, y'all.
Damn.
That's a lot of damn people getting shot. What's going on, Philly?
But it's supposed to be the city of brotherly love.
Yeah, you would think after they heard Corona is now killing African Americans at an alarming rate.
Yeah,
it has increased. You would think, you know what? I know I got beef with you, bro. But let's get
better.
I'm gonna send you a basket full of Robitussin.
You would think
some Vicks vapor rub.
Right. You know what I've been saying? Yeah. Oh, you heard it. You heard that nigga cough? I'm a ride bounty right now. Oh.
Yeah,
when he's at his lowest, right. He's weak in the bed. Oh, I'm a double shoot up the whole house.
Oh.
That's what our people doing, man. 135 shot. Hey, go to Micah chapter 2 real quick and let's read verse 8.
Bring it out. Bring the spirit on that one.
Oh, praise
Micah
man.
Chapter 2 and verse 8.
Bring it out.
Even of late, my people is risen up as an enemy.
An enemy against each other.
Damn.
That's who we are enemy against. An enemy against each other, read.
You pull off the robe with the garment from them that pass by securely as men averse from war.
Pull off the garment means what? You robbing them.
Take off them shoes. I want that new watch you got. That coat you got. Yeah. I want it all.
That's what we doing. We are enemy against each other. And we can't be like that as a people. We got to stop that. Philly, we got to stop the violence. It ain't the only place that got violence.
Right.
But we local news in Philly this week. Philly, get your act together. Repent. Come on. Find your way into IUIC Philly upper with Deacon Ike.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
And you know, they did run who was that? Captain Zakai and Deacon Ithon and Captain Joel. They run some drug dealers off the corner.
That's right.
Up there in Philly not too long ago.
That's right.
With the word of God.
That's right.
It's quicker than, sharper than any two-edged sword.
Yeah.
Hey, so that's it for the local news. Let's go to the international news and see what we got going on. Trump is up here at it again. He ain't only don't give a damn about nobody in America. Nothing but that, that almighty dollar. That's all they care about. But when he comes to international, he pissing off the whole daggone world right now.
Hey.
Pull that article up, man. Let's see what he's doing. Read that, officer.
Road to nowhere. U.S. withdrawal from Open Skies Treaty would undermine its European vessels security.
So the U.S. is pulling out of another treaty. Well, remember, just not too long ago, middle last year, they pulled out of the arms race treaty, right?
They did. Yep. Trump did that.
It was
England was Brexit. Pissed. It was 38 hot at Trump for doing that.
Yeah, yeah.
So they said, it like, what's going on? Even Russia. Russia said something about that as well.
Yeah, so they were free. So now America's free to make as many nuclear bonds. They was already doing it, but
come on.
Now they can make as much as they want to, and they ain't got to hide it from nobody, right? Hey, pull back up the article. Pull it back up. Let's read that real quick.
Washington's hints at potential pullout from the Open Skies Treaty, one of the few remaining arms control mechanisms, proves that it couldn't care less about the security of its vassal states, Russia's deputy FN believes. Signed in 1992 by the U.S., Russia and 32 other states, the Open Skies Agreement remains one of the few arms control accords still in force after the U.S. left the intermediate range nuclear forces.
That's what we talk about, the INF Treaty, the intermediate range nuclear forces. So now they can make nuclear bombs that can travel down around the world two times if they want to. Yep. And for a while, they couldn't do that. Mm. Go back to it. Read.
INF Treaty. It allows the sonorities to conduct unarmed aerial surveillance flights over the territories of other parties to the treaty, Now Washington is pulling out of it as well. And such an outcome, while hardly surprising, would be regrettable. Russian Deputy Foreign Minister
would be regrettable. Read the quote and then pull that script officer. Read that.
Americans have declared that almost all arms control mechanisms fail to meet their interests. Uh-huh. This is a road to nowhere.
No. Grushko, Minister Alakasanda Grushko. This is not a road to nowhere. Yes. It's a road to the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
That's right.
You better believe it.
I told you, man. I told you. I won't allow it.
Not allow y'all talk.
I'm telling you, watch out. Caps Affairs is gonna belly his belly,
man.
DJ, for Trump. It's a road to somewhere. Pull it.
Give me a Revelation chapter 17, verse 16. Because they say it's a road to nowhere. It's a road to somewhere.
Yeah, that's right.
The Lord recorded in the book of Revelation. Read that.
Revelation chapter 17 and verse 16. And the 10 horns.
And the 10 horns, if you don't know, the 10 horns is a European Union.
And the 10 horns, which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore.
These shall do what?
These shall hate the whore.
That's the road that we heading down.
Yeah, right.
That's the road. It ain't no nowhere. They shall hate the whore. The whore is United States of America.
Yeah.
Because they pulling out of all the treaties. They pulling out all the stops. They doing whatever they feel like they want to do. And it's going to piss off the whole world.
Yeah.
Read.
And shall make her desolate.
They said, do what?
Make her desolate.
This European Union is going to make America desolate. How?
And naked. And shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire.
And do what?
Burn her with fire.
That's how it's going to make America desolate.
Yep.
Because they're going to get pissed off. And they gonna Russia gonna rise up and all the other European countries, and they gonna press the damn button. Boom.
That's right.
They gonna press the button, and ain't nothing nobody, no McMichael or no none of them can do nothing against it. Because the Lord already said it.
Yep.
No treaty. Hey, go to Isaiah 46, and I wanna read verse 10 real quick. This is for all of those out there that think that by policy, you can change, you can vote in, all right? Even if the end does not come during the time of DJ Trump. This right here, America pulling out of another world treaty, it ain't nothing but another pawn being moved on the chessboard of God.
Right.
Read that in Isaiah 46 and 10.
Isaiah chapter 46 and verse 10.
Bring it out.
Declaring the end from the beginning and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done.
Yeah.
Saying, my counsel shall stand.
What God has decreed, the counsel is the Bible. It shall stand. And it said what? That the 10 horns, the European Union, they shall hate the whore and burn her with fire.
That's right.
That shall stand. Man. Read on.
And I will do all my pleasure.
Do what?
I will do all my pleasure.
Jump down to verse, read verse 11 now.
Verse 11. Calling a ravenous bird from the east, the man that executeth my counsel from a far country. Yea, I have spoken it. I will also bring it to pass.
Who's that going to execute the judgment from a far country? That's all of them nations that are on the other side of the earth in the east right
now. That's
right.
That's right.
Those are the people that are going to execute God's judgment. Hold on. Read on.
I have purposed it. I will also do it.
I have purposed it. I will also. And remember what the Bible says. God is not a man that he should what?
Lie.
Read it out.
I'll be done.
Right. And that's, let's not look short-sighted. We like to just tick, tick, tick and want stuff to happen right now. Revelation 19 and verse 1. Revelation chapter 19 and verse 1.
Revelation.
Read that.
Chapter 19 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, hallelujah, salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God.
Read.
For true and righteous are his judgments.
That's right.
For he have judged the great whore.
He has the what?
Judged the great whore.
Read.
Which did corrupt the earth. Oh. With her fornication.
Read.
And have avenged the blood of his servants at her hand.
Ooh, verse 3.
Bloody.
And again they said,
Hallelujah. And her smoke rose up forever and ever.
Ooh, that's cold-blooded right there.
That's it.
Cold. And also, Tobias, let me goat back off you real quick. Go to 2 Ezra chapter 11 and verse 40.
Goat back it, okay.
Goat back it. This is a new thing on the face of the earth.
It's clean.
2 Ezra chapter 11 and 40, and then jump down to verse 44.
2 Ezra chapter 11.
So let's see why all the other nations are going to be mad, right? Read.
2 Ezra chapter 11 and verse 40.
Bring it out.
And the fourth came.
The fourth is Rome. Rome, but America is an extension of Rome. Read.
And overcame all the beasts that were past and had power over the world with great fearfulness.
So you see how America is ruling? He's ruling over the world with great fearfulness, right? Read.
And over the whole compass of the earth with much wicked oppression.
So what you see right here is nothing but much wicked oppression. Now let's see how they ruled the other nations. Read.
And so long time dwelt he upon the earth with deceit.
So what you saw there when he had the treaty with the nations, that was pure deceit. Yeah. So now let's jump down and see what the Most High is going to do when he sees nations operating like this. Read.
Verse 44. The highest also had looked upon the proud time.
So when you're dealing with deceit, as far as you're dealing with deceit with the Israelites, you're dealing with deceit with any other nations because God is a just God, then guess what? God says you are dealing in proud time. Read.
The highest also have looked upon the proud times, and behold, they are ended.
God said, that's it for you.
That's it.
That's it. You're going to drop dead.
And,
read.
And what did he say? I shall do all my counsel. Go ahead.
And his abominations are fulfilled.
So all his abominations, all his wicked acts that he's been doing to all the other nations, to us, to Ahmaud Arbery, God says, that's going to be the end of you.
That's right.
That's right.
That means it's coming to you. You just got to endure. Just got to endure. Keep the commandments and the faith in Christ so you can see your salvation. Look up for your redemption drive now.
We used to scream black power while Haram was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.